welcome to tonight's episode of Idle Thoughts. This is part two of a playthrough of a fan-made campaign for Arkham Horror, the card game. So let's get into it. When last we left our intrepid investigators, Lola Hayes and Trish Scarborough, they had just delivered the troublemaking nephew of an aspiring U.S. senator back to his house. The nephew had also put in Trish's purse, or Trish's pack, or whatever Trish is carrying, this thing, a strange idol that seems to be like maybe cursed or something in some way. It's the nephew was kind of raving about it in the taxi cab while they were heading over to the uncle's house. So now we're going to start part two. This is called Enter the Dragon. Let's see how it goes here. Okay, so an investigator's decklist contains a strange idol because we rescued Edmund Bruce. So we go to part one. Sprawling out on the couch, Trish holds the foreign idol up to her face to ponder it again, the ceiling fan listlessly keeping time in the background. The evening sun beams in from her windows and illuminates the figurine, which seemingly shines every possible color, at times white and gold, at others black and blue. Its hollow eyes stare back at her, just as they have the other countless times she's looked over it since her late rising this afternoon. A successful midnight errand deserves a noon's rest. She thinks that it's clear that Edwin slipped it to her in the cab, but why? She thinks back to the startled words he stuttered when she first found him at the Imperial. He obviously had a strong attachment to the figurine, but not enough to stop him from anonymously adding it as gratuity to her fee. At some point, its radiance dies down, and the result she realizes of evening's arrival. Slipping it back in her pocket, she drags herself from the couch, making the minimal effort necessary to tidy up, and she heads out. Considering her recent windfall, she decides to treat herself to the Feast of an Emperor, heading to Chinatown's Phoenix's Nest for its exquisite and exotic dining. I imagine she meets up with Lola Hayes, I guess, along the way, and they have dinner together. An hour later, she pushes her empty plate forward, leaving behind a more than adequate tip, best to pay it forward, and begins to make her way towards the door. And she realizes that if anyone would know anything about the newfound curiosity, it'd be Feng Shao, dealer in all things magnificent and mesmerizing. If anything, at least she could cash it out for a bit more bread. It's been a while since she had last spoke to him, though, and he's as mercurial as he is magnanimous, so she's going to have to ask around to have any hope of finding him. Okay, so now we'll go to setup. So we're going to be heading into Chinatown, and we're going to be starting off at a place called the Phoenix's Nest. Known outside the district for its chop suey, the Phoenix's Nest served a wide variety of food you've never heard of. So we're going to be starting there, and what do we need to do? A friend in need. Wait, stop. Before you can even begin your search, you hear the sound of footsteps pounding on the pavement behind you. Master Feng, they took him. A young man you recognize as Feng's assistant Lu cries out as he leans over next to you, gasping for air. The dragon came and pulled him out of the shop just now. They'll kill him. You've got to find him. You'd hope to avoid any conflict with the local muscle, but it looks like there's no other option. Okay, so it looks like we're going to go look for Master Feng, just as a gang wants him as well. So once again, we are caught in the middle of gang warfare. So here we go. Whenever an investigator defeats a Long Tong enemy, that investigator gains a clue from the token pool, and we're going to need 10 clues to advance. Okay, so that means that defeating gang members is also going to help us advance the act. And what is the agenda up to? Into the Orient. Within the edges of New York's Chinatown lay a world of mystery, a foreign kingdom next door. While most of its inhabitants just tried to make an honest living, the Pocket Empire looked warily upon meddling outsiders. Ling Tong enemies gained spawn and empty location. Okay, so they're not going to jump on us yet. It looks like Long Tong enemies are going to, stay away from us and watch. So we'll keep that in mind. Okay, we've got our encounter deck here. Okay. And now let's go to Lola and Trish here. We've been talking about Trish a lot lately. So we received 6 XP from last scenario. Trish also has the strange idol. This is a next slot that's going to add to her investigations. But whenever she successfully investigates by one or more, she's going to take a horror, but she can rearrange the top 3 cards of the encounter deck. You may Well, not exactly. You may either return them to the top of the encounter deck in their original order or shuffle the encounter deck. Okay, so that'll give us, it'll help out a little bit, but it's going to cost you some horror. Okay, and it can soak up a horror for her as well. Okay, we for doing so well, we have a job well done, so she's going to start off with 6 resources instead of 5. And the upgrades I've made, I took adaptable, and the reason why is because I noticed Trish was really low on willpower. She was having some trouble with willpower tests last scenario, so I've put in 2 copies of Guts in order to help with that. And then I also noticed Trish, she was doing a pretty good job with evading, and she kind of likes money, and she kind of likes succeeding by two or more on things. So we're going to try pickpocketing level 2, because this is just a really good card in general. Being able to, mainly because it's a fast action to play it, so you can play it right when you're about to make a big evade check in order to, so it pays off immediately, and you don't have to spend an action getting it out there. This is actually like a really strong card, and any character who can take it, who does a lot of evading, I think it should be really high on your list. So to go along with what I'm doing here, even though we have Mens Perfecta and Corpus Perfectum in order to help with our evasion and our willpower tests, also to kind of smooth things out a little bit and to make use of the resources that Trish was stacking up, I'm going to try a copy of Moxie. This is a composure from the Path to Carcosa cycle, and it's not really, the composures aren't very well regarded by the community, but I think Moxie is actually way better than it looks, because it helps her. It's going to help with defensive stats, namely willpower and agility, which are pretty common stats for treacheries. So if you run into a tight jam, you can use Moxie to help out. Plus, it's fast, meaning that you don't have to spend an action getting into play. So I'm going to give this a shot. It's going to also boost her willpower along with Guts. And then since we're doing pickpocketing and we want to do some big evades, Moxie is going to help do that as well. So I think there's a lot of synergy between Moxie and the other cards I've picked up for the deck. Okay, so let's shuffle all that good stuff in. Okay. And then we'll just put the permanents aside. Okay, and then you can do it. All right, and now let's go over to Lola Hayes here. So what she did with her 6 experience points, she also got a job well done, which is going to help pay back, you know, some of her debts here. So she gets to start with 4 resources instead of 3. Very nice. So I picked up Easy Marks because it's just a solid card. I replaced emergency caches for Easy Marks because Easy Mark's just better. You get 3 copies of them. They count as 3 of her 7 rogue cards needed to make her three classes that Lola needs in order to, 7 cards of each of 3 different classes. Sorry, I was losing my train of thought there. And just Easy Mark, you don't always need resources, so Easy Mark kind of rewards you for hanging on to it, you know, if you don't need it immediately. So you can hang on to Easy Mark, and then when you draw a second one, you can get a lot of value for playing 2 of them in 1 action. Also, icons. Icons are always nice to see. Lola was having some issues with horror, mainly because her weakness deals some horror. So I've put in a copy of Peter Sylvester, because he's just one of the best cards in the game, honestly. And it's going to let her... Peter's going to soak a lot of horror for her. And it's going to add to her to 2 of her stats. And then I've taken the granddaddy of stat boosts here. Maybe not the granddaddy. More like the father-in-law of stat boosts. In Crystalline Elder Sign. This is actually a very controversial card amongst the Arkham community, because you have to seal the +1. You're not going to seal the Elder Sign. Let's not even go there. Because you have to seal the +1 token. But you get a boost to all 4 stats. That's pretty good. I ended up replacing St. Hubert's Key for this. So, you know, there's a downside that St. Hubert's Key, it can heal you a couple of horror. But I've got Peter Sylvester to help with that. So that kind of, it's kind of a wash there. But the key thing with the Crystal and Elder Sign is it's not just going to help her willpower and her intellect, it's also going to help her combat and her agility. It's going to help Lola do everything, and Lola is kind of an all-around investigator. So this card's really actually like a lot better than it looks. The loss of the +1 in a chaos bag that has 16 tokens in it, it's like the odds of converting a success into a failure is... They're very low, especially when Trish here wants to be boosting pretty high to pass skill checks by at least two. So she's gonna go. Let's say let's take a look at this chaos bag, and I'll show you what I mean. Okay, so this chaos bag, we've got minus ones, we've got minus twos, we've got skulls, which could be, I guess in this case, could be anywhere from minus zero to minus five. We've got cultists, which are minus three, and tablets, which are minus three. Okay, so what's going to happen here is the loss of the plus one. If, like, let's say Trish is like four, like three over on a check. Okay, if she's testing a three over, she is passing the test, assuming she doesn't have more than three horror on her sheet, of course. She's going to be passing the test on everything but the minus four and the tentacle. So she's going to be passing the test 14 out of 16 times. 14 out of 16 pulls on average. So losing the minus one causes her to pass the test on 13 out of 15 tokens. That is a very tiny difference, mathematically. Meanwhile, with Lola, a plus one. So a plus one, what that's going to do, let's say she's making a test and, you know, she's going to be base four at things. Maybe she boosts up to like five and the test is difficulty like two. Okay, thanks to that crystal and elder sign, she went from being a plus two to a plus three. Okay, so being two over to three over. So what would have happened there is by being two over, she's going to make the test on all but the tablet, the cultist, the minus three, and the minus four. So she was going to pass the test 12 out of 16 times. But then by that additional plus one from the crystal and elder sign means she's going to pass the test on the tablet, the cultist, and the minus three. So she goes from passing the test 12 out of 16 times to passing the test on everything but the minus four and the tentacle. So she ends up passing the test, let's see, 13 out of 15 times. Like it's so the benefit to Lola like more than outweighs the loss to Trish, especially since Trish wants to boost pretty high on her tests anyway. Basically, the math checks out. As long as you're playing an investigator that wants to use like three or four of the stats, I think Crystal and Elder Sign is a very strong card, and I think it's very much worth considering in Lola Hayes especially, but also like Diana Stanley if you're playing a build that wants to use not just willpower to do things. I think it's worth it in Akachi or Jim if you're using willpower to do if you're not just using willpower. Also good in, also especially good in Ursula, because Ursula likes, let me pull out Ursula here. Okay. Because Ursula Downs, she has a pretty spread out stat array, and she's pretty good at making evasion checks, and she wants to make evasion checks and intellect checks, and often often willpower checks for treacheries. She often wants to use all three out of the four stats. So Crystal and Elder Sign is very good for her. Note that she can take relic cards up from zero to four, which includes Crystal and Elder Sign. So there are actually quite a lot of investigators who really like Crystal and Elder Sign. It's a very underrated card by the community, but I like it a lot. And you know, we'll see if Lola can get it in order to show off how good it is. Okay, so I've set everything up. We've got our board. And let's go to opening hands. Okay, here we go. As usual, we're probably looking for clue tools, since we're pretty decent at the evasions. All right, we'll start with Lola here. Here we go. Oh, let's hide that. Okay, so what have we got here? We've got Act of Desperation, which we totally don't need it at the start. We've got Hallowed Mirror, which we also don't need at the start because we have no damage to heal. Find Clothes is nice because it can help us parlay. Easy Mark is always good to see early on. And Tor Port is also good if we have a High Shroud location. So I think I'm just going to mulligan these two and hope for more assets. Okay, here we go. Okay, well, Peter Sylvester is nice to see, but I would have really liked to see like a weapon or a fingerprint kit at this point. That being said, she's probably going to be okay. And I think what I'll do is I'll have her start in Survivor so she can just put Peter Sylvester out and, you know, get him rolling. Okay, so over to Trish. Whoops, I gotta shuffle this deck. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, we've got some engines going. We've got Mr. Rook, we've got Enchanted Blade, we've got Fingerprint Kit. Okay, so Trish is off to a pretty good start already. Since we already have a weapon, we don't even need the Prepared for the Worst. So I'll just replace that With a lone wolf. Oh my gosh. Triss is off to a pretty good start with like solid assets here. Yeah, that's great. In fact, yeah, I'm probably gonna have Trish go first just to, because yeah, the possibilities are endless. All right, so we're gonna start at the Phoenix's Nest. Okay. It's got two clues. Let's see. And as an action, you could spend a resource to heal a damage here because I guess you go get something to eat. The food of the nest offered a glorious rebirth even after the roughest of nights. Okay, so let's get started. We need 10 clues. So, two is not going to do it, but two is enough to get us started. So, let's begin with Trish because she has some pretty cool possibilities here. So, I think what I'll do is I'll start off by putting Mr. Rook into play. Okay, giving him three secrets and then immediately using Mr. Rook. Let's go see what we can see. All right, so we're going to look at the top nine. Okay, here we go. Come on. Okay, so we don't have. Oh, we've got our weakness. Good to see that sooner rather than later. Okay, but we don't have an astounding revelation. We've already got a weapon, so I don't think I need the Derringer. I could grab that just to get the investigation started. That does deal horror, and horror is kind of awful. I could get Gregory Gry. But no, I've already filled up my ally slot. So I think I'm actually going to grab calling in favors to when it comes time to reset Mr. Rook. So I'll just do that. All right. Then we'll give this a shuffle. Okay. Okay, so we've got Shadowy Cabal. So she needs to successfully investigate three places. Okay. I don't have enough to pay for the fingerprint kit. So I think what I'll do is I can get Lone Wolf into play. Yep, better now than later. So I'll get Lone Wolf into play. Okay, and then third action. Let's see. Well, I can't really afford anything right now. I can have her just investigate. Yeah, seems fine. She'd be at three versus two. It's not the worst. I could also just draw. Now we'll investigate. We'll be at three versus two. Do I use Mens Perfecta? Yeah, I think so. Because if I run into some bad guys, she might. Yeah, I'll use Mens Perfecta. So I'm going to be at 5 versus 2. Flip that. And we'll be at 5 versus 2. Minus 3 is a success. So we deal with that and get a clue. Okay, so it was an okay start. Yeah, it's an okay start. Hopefully, we'll get the money train rolling here pretty soon. Okay, over to Lola. Okay, so as I mentioned, I'm going to play Peter Sylvester first in order to get the horror soak rolling. All right, then I think what I'm going to do with my second action is let's get some cards and resources. So I'll play Easy Mark, two resources and a card. Tetsuo Mori. Okay, well, too late, Tetsuo. I don't think we're going to be getting you into play. Okay, so third action, let's stay together because I would like to have them separate so Lone Wolf can trigger, but I can do that next turn. So let's get Fine Clothes into play. Okay, so that way we can parlay when those checks inevitably come up. Plus, it gets some like physical soak in there. Okay, so that is all of our actions. We have no baddies on the board, so let's go to upkeep. So we're gonna get a card and a resource. Take the initiative is always good to see. All right, and over here we'll get a card and a resource. Another enchanted blade. Okay, so I don't need the second one. Looks like we're probably set for weapons for the game though. Okay, new turn. We're going to go to one doom out of three. Ooh, three. Not as much as I thought it was going to be. Okay, so we'll get some encounter cards. Fangs of the Dragon. Spawns at Zhihao's House of Fighting Arts. It has Hunter and Retaliate. Okay, the muscle of the Long Tong was known for its imposing armor and frighteningly large knives. While perhaps old-fashioned, the getup did a good job of scaring away nosy foreigners. Okay, so it's at House of Fighting Arts. Where is that? There it is. Okay, so he's all the way up there right now. Okay, so thanks to connections, he's like two spaces away, so we don't have to deal with him immediately. Wall of Babel. Attached to your location, if there are no clues on it, it gains surge. Location gets plus two shroud. And as a free action, you can discard a card with the willpower icon to get plus two on your next investigate. Ah, I see. Okay, and at the end of the investigation phase, if no clues are on the attached location, shuffle Wall of Babel back into the encounter deck. That's kind of an interesting card. It's like an obscuring mist that like keeps coming back, but also gives you a way to overcome it if you're not that great at investigation. So this is now Shroud 4. Yikes. Shroud 4 is kind of a lot, especially since we can't boost our willpower right now. All right, so to start things off, during the first action window we get, we're going to have Trish use Mr. Rick, and let's see what she gets. So we're going to look at the top 9. Hopefully we'll see our astounding revelation this time. We see astounding revelation. That's great, and we need the resources. And so I'll get 2 resources. There's no weakness here. That's also good. Okay. I've already got a calling in favors. I don't think I need another one. I could grab the strange idol, because she's going to be investigating a lot. And the problem is she's going to take horror off of it. That's what worries me. But then again, since I have no other slot, it's probably worth it. Okay, fine. I'll get it. Although, guts could be good right now. Or quick thinking. Well, we're dealing with a 4-shard location, so let's grab this strange idol. Okay. Okay, give this a shuffle. Okay. I'll have Brooke soak the horror. Okay, so we've done that. We want Lola to go first, so that way Lola and Wolf can trigger. So we're going to have Lola... I don't have any weapons, so I guess we'll just have her move. How is she doing her resources? She's got 3. Okay. So where do we want to go? Do we want to go gateway to the east or back alley? Let's go to the gateway to the east. I'm astounded by people who want to know the universe when it's hard enough to find your way around Chinatown. Okay, so we... Shroud 2, 1 clue, and we can resign from here. I need a new line of work. You get the feeling that this will be the last sign you'll see tonight that you could read. Okay, that's pretty good. If we were to investigate here, we'd be at 3 versus 2, which is not that great. I think Lola just needs some more stat boosters, so she probably just needs more cards. That's our first action. We can leave that clue for Trish because it'll help with the Shadowy Cabal. We don't want to move up any farther because then the single hunter down. And she doesn't have a weapon yet, so I'm thinking we actually need to draw until we get a weapon. So second action, I'll draw. Okay. Third action, draw again. Oh, there we go. That'll help with investigations. Okay, do I want to stay a rogue? Let's go to Seeker, because I have a feeling what I'll do first is plop down this magnifying glass. Okay, so kind of a slow turn for Lola there. Okay, so Trish, she's going to start off with triggering Lone Wolf. Let's go first action, play the Strange Idol. Okay, so if she investigates, she's going to be at 4 versus 4. Can't dump anything to make that any bigger. 4 versus 4, not so great. Yeah, I could just leave the clue behind. Yick. Not so great. Can I boost it? I don't want to drop that. I don't want to drop that, so I can't really boost it. I could spend 3 and getting the Enchanted Blade out, so that way if baddies show up, then we'll be okay. Okay, so I'm thinking what we'll do here is we'll move to a new location. If I go here or here, this guy won't be able to hunt. So we can go to Golden Temple of the Heavens or the back alley. Yeah, we'll just go... Let's second action play an Enchanted Blade. Okay, so that way we are armed up, we're ready to go. And then third action, let's go here. Golden Temple of the Heavens. It didn't take much fluency to understand that this small building was the heart of the district. For those that sought the advice of destiny, there was no thought of another oracle. Okay, so we've got 4 clues here. That's pretty good. And, okay. So you can spend a resource to discard a non-weakness treachery card from your threat area. Empty the clear path to heaven, crowded the dark road to hell. Okay. So if we run into some nasty treacheries, we can clear them at the cost of a resource. Okay, so that was all of our actions. Not a lot going on that turn. We've also got this guy hunting us down, so I think we're going to have Trish go get it. All right, so let's go to upkeep. So we're going to get a card and a resource. Prophesy, that's always good to see. And then we'll get a card and a resource. Gregory Guy, okay. That is totally not what we wanted to see. We wanted to see him when we play Calling in Favors. So, awful. Okay, new turn. We're going to go to 2 to an amount of 3. So the agenda is going to advance next turn. And then we'll get encounter cards. Shanghai. Revelation. Test intellect at 4. If you fail, move to the dark location furthest from you. Then take a damage on a horror. Oh, dear. Dark location furthest from you. Oh, like all the way back there. Okay, that's probably not the worst thing that can happen right now, right? So let's just take it on the chin. Okay, we're at 3 versus 4. Okay, so we fail. We're gonna take a damage in a horror, so we'll take a damage here. Horror and Peter Sylvester. And we get sent to, I guess, furthest from you. So 1, 2, 3. One, nothing's more than 3 away. So we could go. That's only 2. So I guess we get sent here. The flea market. Maybe we take a wrong turn. While it operated under the guise of a collection of foreign traders, the flea market in the northeast of Chinatown was a well-known source of the kind of merchandise you didn't advertise. Oh, okay. 4 shroud, 2 clues. Pretty nice. Illicit relic and criminal assets cost 2 fewer resources to play here. When you leave this location, though, lose 2 resources. Larceny loves company. Oh, I see you get your pickpocketed, your pocket picked. Peter packed a pickle pocket. Okay, so we got over here. Dragon Dance Parade. Okay, so this one is a surge, and this is a known issue with this current publication of this is that there should be 4 Dragon Dance Parades, one for north, south, east, and west. So I have this die to roll. So apparently in this iteration of the scenario, mistakenly, all 4 copies of this are south when there should be one of each. So I'm gonna go number 1, 2, 3, 4, and we'll go clockwise. So we're gonna roll this die, and what do we get? We've got a 2, so this is gonna be Dragon Dance Parade East. Okay, attach it to the current agenda, discarding any previously attached copies. Whenever an investigator enters or leaves an east location, he or she loses 1 action. All right, so I'll just attach it over here. Let's put it over here, so just so we can know that. And then it surges. What we got? A Taste of Dreams. Test willpower at 3. Increase this test difficulty by 1 if you have 3 or fewer remaining sanity. For each point you fail by, you must either take a damage or lose a resource. Of all the remedies, it has pleased Almighty God to give man to relieve his suffering. None is so universal and so efficacious as opium. All right, so we're going to be testing at willpower against willpower 3. We're currently a 3. Let's use Mr. Rook while the action window's there, and let's keep digging for our astounding revelations. Whoops. Search. What do we got? Oh, there's an astounding revelation. That is good to see. Do I want resources or do I want cards? Oh, do I want another secret? I'll take resources actually, because I'm low on those. All right, so I get to. There's no weakness here. So I'm thinking I'm going to end up going with probably Moxie or a second pickpocketing. That would be hilarious. Second pickpocketing would be pretty hilarious. Okay, so to make this check, I'm at 3 versus 3. If I fail it, for each point you fail by, you must either take a damage or lose a resource. Okay, so I can let Rook take some damage if I fail. So I don't necessarily need to make this check. I want to leave Gregory Gry in there because I'm hoping to hit him with calling in favors. So let's pull the Moxie, I think. Yeah, that'll save some damage. I can't play it right now, but I think the Moxie seems pretty good. It costs a lot of resources though, and I don't have a lot of them yet. I haven't gotten the train really out of the station. What am I dealing with? Shroud 3. I'm currently at a 4 to investigate. Okay, so maybe it's fingerprint kit time. Okay, so if that's the case, I think I'm going to go for the intel report. Okay, I'll take an intel report. Because, investigate. If I run into another high shroud location, I can spend money on, grabbing clues. Okay, so we've used Mr. Rook. We are currently at 3 versus 3, and I think we're just going to take it on the chin. 0, so we succeed. Oh, that's good. Okay. Oh, I don't have enough time for calling in favors. It's fine. It's fine. I'll be okay. All right, so what do we do here? Let's just have Trish. Oh, we've got this guy. Do we want to go beat him up? How is he? He's easier to evade than to beat up. Let's get stay focused. We'll just have it come after Trish and have her take a couple bit of damage. I'll put some of it on Mr. Rook, and then she'll probably evade it next turn with pickpocketing, or she can attack it with the Enchanted Blade. So what we'll do is at the start of her turn, we're gonna get Lone Wolf, and then we're gonna go first action fingerprint kit. Okay. Second action, we'll use the fingerprint kit, and we'll test at 5 versus 3 here. Seems okay. I'm thinking about putting in Gregory Gry because I don't want to. Yeah, I'll put in Gregory Gry. So now we're gonna be 3 over. Okay, so we succeed by 1. Yep, we succeed by one. That's too bad. So I get two clues. I put in Gregory Gry because I'm hoping to use Calling in Favors to grab another ally pretty soon. Okay, so that was... Oh, and I succeeded by one or more. So we're going to be taking a horror off of this. We look at the top three cards in the encounter deck. You can either return them to the top of the encounter deck or shuffle the encounter deck. All right, so what are we going to get? We're going to... So this is the top one. Okay, this is the next one, and this is the next one. Okay, so what's going to happen next? We know that Lola's going to get a Breath of the Dragon. And it's going to happen after the agenda advances, so this is going to jump on top of her. It's not too hard to deal with. Okay, and then Trish is going to get this. Take two horror and draw two cards, or put one doom on the current agenda. Take two horror and draw two cards. That's kind of neat. Okay, so that's what's coming. How bad is that? Considering that Lola doesn't have a weapon right now, that is actually pretty bad. Okay, so I think I'm going to have Trish shuffle the encounter deck. Okay. It's actually kind of worth a horror, being able to see what's coming up next and, you know, change your fate. Okay, so we're going to have Mr. Rook take the horror for her. All right. So that was her second action. We know that this guy's coming. Oh, she discovered clues for a new location, so that goes away. So I could either take the damage from him or I can leave. Loses an action. I can leave over here. And then don't have to deal with him just yet. Probably makes sense because, well, next turn I'll be able to go pickpocketing, spend two on pickpocketing, start evading. I won't be able to use Corpus Perfectum. All right, so let's leave. I want to deal with that, but nah, let's head out. Go back here to the back alley. There's probably not a city in the world where an unlit avenue is a smart place to go, but it's the shortest path from point C to point I. Oh, I get it. From point C to point I, which is not on the board. All right. One shroud, and it's got two clues. Long tongue enemies at this location get +1 evade. Okay. Even in the brightest of daylight, some paths are never illuminated. Okay, so I think what's going to happen is, as long as Lola doesn't end up here, we're going to have this guy, you know, hunt over there. Okay, so what do we got? Illicit relic and criminals cost less. Do we have any of those? I don't think so. No. So we need Lola, and it's worth a victory point, so Lola likes probably should investigate this. Right now we are at 3 to investigate against a shroud 4. Not so great. This is probably where Intel Report is going to save us. Through that, or I can put in like Prophesy. Nah, it's only worth 1 because there's only 2 Doom in play. So I think we're going to use... Either that or I can go 4 over, do Magnifying Glass, pitch in Tetsuo. Intel Report is what we want. It's what, Shroud 4? Yeah, this is why we have the Intel Report. Oh, I got to switch to Rogue. Play Intel Report. Get 2 clues. Okay, so how are we doing on clues? We've got 5 out of 10. Okay, so here's the thing. If she leaves now, she has no resources to lose, so there's no pocket to pick. But if she leaves now, this guy's going to jump on her. So I think what we'll do is we'll build up towards spending all our money and then leave when it's safe. How are we going to do that? I've already swapped to Rogue. What would I spend my money on? Probably another Intel Report. Is it worth just taking resources? Yeah, I kind of think so. Another thing I could have done is I could have done... as a Seeker, I could have done like play the Magnifying Glass, then take a resource, then play Intel Report. But then if I'm investigating, I'm still at 4 versus 4, which is not so great. Especially since... Yeah, there's some if-you-fail effects here. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll just take a resource and build up to the next Intel Report. It's not... sexy, but it'll probably be fine. Okay. So what did I do? I did first action into report, and I'll just take two resources. Okay, so that is all our actions. This means that the Fangs of the Dragon chases Trish some more, and now we'll go to cards and resources. Oh, and Peter heals. Okay, so card and resource, exactly what I need. That's great. That'll help us pay for this intel report. Okay, and then over here, we're going to go refresh, card, and resource. Moxie, okay. New turn. Agenda's going to advance. Okay, I'm not sure what... I have no idea what's going to happen, because I've never played this before. Well, let's see. Night Under the World. As the night creeps on, you begin to feel that you've left the familiar streets of New York far, far behind you. It may be a good idea to keep track of the quickest way out of here in case things turn south. Discard cards to the encounter deck until a copy of Dragon Dance Parade is discarded. Attach that card to Agenda 2A, discarding any previously attached treacheries. Okay, so we're going to get a new Dragon Dance Parade. Okay, so this one's going to go away. Okay, so this one was West. So whichever one we get is going to be not that one. So, okay... Dragon Dance Parade, looking for it. Looking for it. Oh, where are they? Oh, man. Keep discarding. Keep discarding. Keep discarding. Oh, wow, where did they all go? Maybe the bug is that there's only one copy. Oh, here we go. Okay, so that one's discarded. We're going to do... So we know it has to be a different one, so we're just going to roll the dice again. What do we get? We got a 4. That wasn't a roll. Man, that's not a roll at all. It's like, you gotta toss this thing up in the air. There we go. Okay, I guess a 4. Okay, that works fine. All right, so that means it goes west. 1, 2, 3, 4. Uh-oh, right on top of Trish. What does that mean? Whenever she enters or leaves a west location, she's going to lose one action. Okay, that's troublesome. Okay. Agenda 2, Eyes in the Dark. The streets close in around you as a concoction of mist clouds your vision. Oh dear. Piercing through the haze, you can feel the stare of those curious about the intrepid outsiders wandering the alleyways. Some of these observers don't seem content to just watch. Oh right, so now the Long Tong are going to jump on us instead of just watch us from a space away. That's going to be a problem. Okay, so now we're going to go to encounter cards. What do we got? Swan Ming. A curse put in your threat area. You get -1 to all skill checks. If you fail a skill check, add 1 doom to the current agenda and discard this card. If you succeeded a skill check by 1 or more, discard this card. This is actually kind of a cool card, to be honest. Yeah, because it, like, I kind of like this card, actually. That's kind of neat. It's a very, it's a much more, like, interesting design than, like, Ancient Evils. And it gives you a way out of it. But at a cost. Okay. Waking Nightmare. Test willpower at 4. For each point you fail by, either take a horror or discard a card. Dark secrets guarded for a lifetime can be divulged with carefree folly after a sip of the black smoke. Okay, so what are we at? It's a willpower test. We're currently at 3 versus 4. And for each point you fail by, take a horror or discard the card. I don't really want to take horror right now. Oh man, I wish I had Moxie in play. But I have really no way to boost this. Because Corpus Perfectum is not going to help me. Alright, so here we go. Hope we don't draw too badly. 0. Okay, so we only fail by 1. So I can either discard it, take a horror, or discard a card. I'm tempted to discard the Enchanted Blade, but I could use it to fight this guy. All right, so let's just take a horror. Okay. Okay, that is minus X and X's. So her skulls are -1 now. Okay, that's what that is. All right, so what do we need to do? We want to grab some clues, but then we got this guy chasing us. Okay. That's not too bad, because we can put 1 of the damage on Mr. Rook, 1 of the damage on Lola, on Trish, and then we can use Calling in Favors. We've only got 1, so... And then we only have 1. If we go up to 2, we'll be able to use pickpocketing, but then the problem is in order to move to him, and then just to evade him, we'd have to spend 2 actions to get there. So I think we're just going to have to let him come to us, and we can work on getting these 2 clues. And as a part of that, I can try to succeed by 2 or more on the investigate here. That'll help us with our resource issue. Okay, so we're going to have Trish go first. Let's trigger Lone Wolf. Okay, so first action, I'll use Fingerprint Kit. I'm going to be at 3, 4, 5 versus 1. Okay, that feels pretty good. 5 -3, so I succeed by 1. Ah, dang it. 3, 4, 5 versus 1. Okay, I succeed by 1. Okay. Is that a fresh location? I believe it is. So we have cleared Shadowy Cabal, and we get the 2 clues. So right now we are at 7 clues out of 10. Doing okay. I succeeded by 1, which is enough for this. Okay, so let's see what's coming up. Top, middle, third. All right, so next Lola is going to get Scales of the Dragon. Tactical skills of the dragon, the long enemy with the lowest remaining health. Next time, so take any amount of damage. Instead, cancel that damage and discard a copy of Scales of the Dragon. And then Trish is going to get shanghaied, which is actually not too bad for her, considering she's kind of trapped where she is now. And then Cryptic Symbols is going to come up. You may not gain or spend clues. Yuck. Okay, so we're just going to have to take it, knowing what it is. Okay, so we know that Lola is going to draw this, which is not going to do anything to her. Instead, it's going to make this guy a bit tougher, and which means that Trish is going to have to double down on the evasion plan. Okay. All right, so that was action one. Okay, so if this guy walks in and steps on Trish, she's going to take 2 damage, and she'll probably be okay. I think she can deal with it. All right, so in case we run into some more evasion checks and stuff, let's get the Moxie in play. Put it right there. And then third action... Oh, I can play Calling in Favors. No, let's play Calling in Favors instead of Moxie. Second action, Calling in Favors. Although, we're going to need Rook to take the soak. It's only 1 damage. Yeah, what's Gregory Gry's stats again? He only takes damage to be defeated. Okay, so we're going to Calling in Favors after Rook has taken some damage for us. So let's spend that resource. Going down to 1 resource, get the Moxie in play. Third action, I don't feel that great of a need to draw, so let's just take a resource, I think. Yeah, it'll be okay. Okay, over to Lola. Let's go. We want to grab those 2, so we're going to go... Oh, we've got this as well. So she's bad at skill checks, but she can make the intel report. So do I want to use improvisation on it? I kind of do. Because I don't have any other assets to really... I don't have any other cards to really spend money on. So I'll... Okay, I know what I'll do. So I don't have to swap in a seeker later. I'll just swap in a seeker with her, you know, her normal swap. Spend a resource to put the magnifying glass into play. Okay, so now I'm going to play improvisation. Okay, swap to rogue, and then draw a card. Okay, and that means this intel report is going to cost 3 less, so it's going to cost 1, and she's going to grab both these clues. Okay, that means if she leaves the area now, she's going to lose her last resource, but that's probably okay. I mean, yeah. Okay, so second action, she leaves. And she's going to lose a resource. Okay, that's not illicit, is it? No. Yeah. And let's see where she ends up. North. You'd seen photos of Johnson and Dempsey thrashing lesser men in the papers before, but you'd never quite seen fighting like the kind that took place in these walls, the House of Fighting Arts. Okay, it's another victory point, which is good. This location is investigated with combat instead of intellect, because we're going into the House of Fighting Arts. That's kind of cool. Alright. So now, if we were to investigate here, we'd be at 4 versus 3, but 3 versus 3, thanks to Swan Ming. So, I think what I'll do is take the initiative next turn to try to clear Swan Ming with an investigation test. That's probably going to be the plan. Another thing I could do is pitch in an unexpected courage, and I'd be 2 over. Now, I need to succeed by 1 or more in order to get rid of this, so I think I'll use Take the Initiative to clear that next turn. So that's my second action. I don't need to spend any money on anything right now, so I could just draw a card. Yeah, it seems fine. What are we doing? Oh, we're 9 clues out of 10. Okay, just take a card. Easy mark. Very good to see, actually. Okay, so that's all our actions. As we said, this guy's going to hunt, and he's going to jump on Trish, and she's going to take a damage and a horror. Okay. Oh, he retaliates too. Okay. Now we're going to go to upkeep. So we get a doom and a resource. Not doom. Card and a resource. Card and resource. Okay, that's good to see. All right, new turn. We're at 1 doom out of 6. And I'll draw encounter cards. As we saw, Eyes of the Dragon. Scales of the Dragon. It's going to have a little shield to block him from a burst of damage. And then she's going to get shanghaied, so we are at 3, 4 versus 4. If we fail, we're going to take a damage and a horror. Is this worth using Moxie on? No, we can't use Moxie on that. Could be worth using Intel Report on, though. That's a good question, because if I get zipped away, I also get moved away from the Dragon Dance Parade, but is it damage and a horror? And then if I leave here, I lose 2 resources, so that might be awful. Illicit. Oh, I could play my pickpocketing for free. That's cool. All right, so that kind of pays for itself. Okay, I'll be fine. All right, so I'm just gonna take the test at evens. Okay, skull. Skull is currently minus one, so she fails by one. Okay, and so she gets swept off to the, to the flea market. Yep, swept off to the flea market. Takes damage on a horror. Well, I don't want to kill Mr. I don't want to lose Mr. Rook, because I want to use calling in favors. So, yep, I'll do that. Okay, she's been shanghaied. Okay, so as we mentioned with Trish, I want to use pickpocketing to evade him. Fortunately, we're in the flea market, so this illicit asset is it costs less. So let's it's there. So let's get this pickpocketing into play. Oh, the Moxie was supposed to take the horror for us. Whoops. I maybe should have lost Mr. Rook, because Moxie's cool and we're starting to get the resources going. Let's stay on target with calling in favors. Yeah. Okay. So I lose the Moxie. Okay, so we play this for free. And now we're gonna go evade this guy. So we're currently at three to evade. Three to evade, that's it. Okay, well, I'll three versus two. I'll use Corpus Perfectum to go to five versus two. Five versus two. I want to evade by two or more. So let's go to six, seven versus two. Seven, five. So that's a result of five. So we succeed by three, which means we get this to get a card and a resource. Oh, I was going to use calling in favors on you. We evade this guy. We get a resource off of Trish. And I think that's all. Dang it. I was going to use a resource. I wanted you with calling in favors. Is he at least a criminal? Goodness. Was a criminal, so he'd cost us one. Could try the calling in favors to get a rook. Yuck. Let's see. Ally, illicit relics and criminals. Yeah, let's go for the rook, see what happens. Okay, so second action, let's go calling in favors to try to get to return Mr. Rook to our hand. Fully healed. And look at the top nine. Oh, whoops. That was top eight for some weird reason. Oh well. Well, he's in there, so that's good. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll these are the eight I'm looking at, and then I'll add this to that deck because I'm supposed to be looking at these. Okay, so we get our Mr. Rook. Okay, so he gets put into play for free. Okay, and that's it. Okay, right. This isn't Mr. Rook. I don't get to pick a card. I just get to pick an ally. Okay, that's good. Let's immediately use Mr. Rook to look at the top nine again. Okay. Top nine. Okay, we get our weakness, and we get to pick a card. Oh, we get an astounding revelation to get some resources. Nice. And we get to pick a card. What do I want? I've got five. I could probably use my intel reports, to be honest. Fingerprint gets going to run out too. Don't need prepared for the worst. Quick thinking might be good here at this juncture. I think quick thinking actually is probably what we're gonna need. Okay, so I'll do that. You're just stuffing investigation location with no clues on it. Okay, so that's that. We've got a good amount of resources now. That was action two. No clues here. Do I want to run away from this guy at this point? Probably, yeah. But I lose two resources when I do it. I can't quite spend enough to clear out with intel report. Clear out like two of those. So yeah, let's just move. Stay away from this guy. So we lose two resources when we leave. Which all in all is probably fine. Okay, so how are we doing? We are at 9 clues out of 10. Okay, and that was Trish's turn. Now it's Lola's turn. Oh, she can also. Okay, we've got difficulty. Okay, so that's with combat. So she's currently three versus, well, two versus three on that. To investigate there? Not the best. Oh, I should have gone first and used take the initiative. I screwed up. Okay. Let's go dig for like a fingerprint kit or something. So I'll play Easy Mark as the first action. Read the signs. That is nice to see, because that'll help us with this. Okay, what are we at? We are at -1 to all skill checks. Okay, so if I were to play Read the Signs, I'd be at... I am investigating, but I wouldn't get that. I'd have to use my combat and my willpower. So combat's at 3, willpower's at 4. I'd be at 7 minus 1 for Swan Ming means be at 6, 6 versus 3. Pretty good. I do want to succeed by 1 or more, so I'll probably put in the Unexpected Courage. Okay, that's what I'll do. Let's ignore... Effect or keyword which would trigger during this investigation. That's not a triggered effect, so I'm just going to deal with it. All right, second action, play Read the Signs. I'm going to be at, like I said, I'm going to use my use combat plus willpower. So I'll be at 7, minus 1 for Swan Ming is 6, plus 2 for Unexpected Courage is 8 against 3. Okay, 8 minus 1 is 7 against 3, so I succeed by enough to get rid of Swan Ming, and I get 2 clues. So we can advance if we want to. I think we'll want to wait till next turn, though, when we have a fresh set of actions. So that was second action. Third action, I could stay here. Nah, she's only 3 versus 3 to her checks there. I could just take a card. They can stay together to deal with the problems. That's probably fine. Okay, I can take a resource now. I've got improvisation in case I need resources, so I'll take a card. Okay, that's third action. Oh, here we go. We've got a weapon. That's good to see. Okay, so that is all our actions. So we're going to have no hunters, and then this guy's going to refresh himself during upkeep, and we're both going to get cards and resources. Okay, fingerprint kit, also what I was looking for. Okay, and we get card and resource. All right, so we're ready to evade the Ling Tong. The Long Tongue. Okay, new turn. We're at 2 doom out of 6, and we knew what that is, but we don't know what this is. Cryptic symbols. Add it to your threat area. You may not gain or spend clues. Oh, but we gotta make a test to clear that. Okay, that's fine. Then we have Dragon Dance Parade. Okay, so the current one is West, so we're gonna roll to see where this one goes. Yeah, we need like a real roll here. Come on. No, that's not a real roll. That's a real roll. Okay, where is it? 4 again. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, we know it's not west, so we need to make sure it goes to a different location. So try again. 2. Yeah, so that's there. Okay, so that'll go there. Discard that. Is that correct? Discarding previously attached copies. Okay, so that's over there. Okay. Now what? We need to get rid of this in order to advance. Okay, Lola's currently at 3 versus 3 to do that. More refuses to take the initiative. So I'll probably do that. Yeah, it sounds good. Trish is at 4 versus 3 to do that. Okay. During the first action window she gets, though, we'll have her use Mr. Rook. Okay, look at the top 9. Whoops. Look at the top 9. What do we get here? What do we want? We don't need that right now. We're doing pretty well. Well, maybe I can grab the second calling in favors, but there's nothing to really pull with calling in favors at the moment because all the other allies are here. So let's grab... We don't need the cigarette case. Let's grab quick thinking and start working on like some power turns here. Okay. Oops. Ah, what the heck? Gah. Okay. So that was a non-action. Okay, so I think what I'll do... I'll have Lola make this test, and I'll have Trish pitch into it. How much doom is on the agenda? 2? Okay, so we're going to have her burn take the initiative. She's going to be at 6 versus 3, which is pretty good.
Yeah, we'll do that. Six versus three. Minus three. Okay, so we succeeded on the nose and discard that. Okay, so that was our first action. Now we'll spend 10 clues. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, there we go. All right, so we will advance. The Dragon's Hoard. Through methods perhaps more brutal than you're used to, you manage to find out that the Long Tong are holding Fang Xiao in their opium joint, the Dragon's Den, somewhere on the northern edge of Chinatown. You get the feeling that there won't be any more neon signs out front, though, so finding may require a bit more asking around. Shuffle the set-aside copy of the Dragon's Den and the top two cards of the encounter deck. Place these cards face down under each north location, one per location. Okay, so what did it say? Set aside Dragon's Den? Okay. Okay. And the top two counter cards. Oh, I see. So it's going to be like randomized where it is. Discard cards from the top encounter deck until a Long Kong enemy is revealed and spawned at Xichao's School of Fighting Arts. Okay, so that's gonna. Okay, let's do some. Just put these like right next to. Well, now I know which one it is because it spawned clues. So let's try that again. So that one's gonna be there, and that one's gonna be there. Okay, so it's gonna discard cards from the top encounter deck until a Long Tong enemy is revealed and spawn at Xichao School of Fighting Arts. So does it reset itself? I mean, we're in the investigator phase. Does the encounter deck always reset itself? You know what? I'm gonna look this up because this doesn't come up very often, but I should know this. But I'm gonna look this up and I'm gonna be right back. Okay. And we're back. So it turns out that while you are resolving an effect that is about, while in the you're in the midst of resolving an effect, you do not shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck if the encounter deck runs out. So what happens here is that we're discarding cards, the encounter deck runs out, so we don't get a where'd it go? We don't get a Long Tong enemy. Instead, we just reshuffle the discard pile into the encounter deck after the effect fails to resolve. This is a question that came up for Zoe's signature weakness, Smite the Wicked. And that's how it's been ruled to work. Because I guess you can hit a point where if there were no Long Tong enemies in the deck, you would have to keep discarding cards forever. And that wouldn't fly. Okay, so we have that was the first action of Lola's turn. And now we go to Act Two, The Clutches of the Monster. If you want to find your friend alive, you better get to the Dragon's Den on the double. The last thug you spoke to said it was somewhere on the north edge of Chinatown. Whenever an investigator defeats a Long Tong enemy, that investigator gains a clue from the token pool. Each north location gains. Spend four clues as a group to draw the encounter card underneath this location. If it is the Dragon's Den, attach it to this location. Group limit once per game. Okay. Objective: the Dragon's Den has been revealed, and there are no clues remaining on it. Advance. Okay, so we need to get clues, and we just spend them in order to find the Dragon's Den. We have one clue left, so we're gonna have to just keep on keeping on. All right. So Lola has two actions left. So I guess the good question is: do we want to like lure this guy in, or do we want to like step on this guy? Lola doesn't really have a lot of resources right now, so I think I'm gonna have her. I think it's time for her to play an Enchanted Blade. Or we can have her play a fingerprint kit and start investigating over here. This actually seems pretty good too. All right, so we'll have Lola take her second action to go to Dayu's Tea Garden. You could get a good cup of tea here, but Dayu's establishment was better known for its vicious mahjong games and the cutthroat women who played them. Okay. What do we got here? Shroud 3, four clues. Victory 1, that's good. You must have at least one resource to investigate this location. Right, because you've got to have money to sit down at the mahjong table. If you succeed at an investigate test at this location, gain a resource. If you fail an investigate check at this location, lose a resource. If you pull the auto fail while investigating at this location, lose all your resources. I see. So we're investigating by playing mahjong. Oh, that's hilarious. Okay, so that was our second action. So if we're going to be doing investigations, so I think what I'll do is I'll play improvisation. Okay, so I'll swap to seeker and then get a card. Okay, and then that'll means that this fingerprint kit will cost us only cost us one. Okay, so that was all three of Lola's actions. She's ready to go play mahjong. That's pretty funny. Okay, so over here to Trish. Okay, I don't want to, I could she could afford to take a bit of damage. I could also move in. If I moved in and I start evading him, that works pretty well too. She's got a full hand, so maybe she can just go for some investigations. What do we got? Shroud 3, Shroud 4, Shroud 3. We could spend our 4 resources to play intel report here. That'll cover those, which actually seems pretty strong. And then she can go move and then start working on the, maybe evade this guy. I won't be able to afford the, just that pickpocketing. Okay, but let's go for it. Okay, so first action I'm going to play into... Oh, first I'm going to trigger Lone Wolf. Then first action I'll play into report to grab 2 clues off of here. Okay. All right, done that. Okay, now we've got to deal with this guy. I'm going to have to deal with this at some point. Let's see. If I were to investigate here, I'd have to use my combat, so I'd only be at 3 versus 3. Not so good. Not so good. So maybe I move in here and start evading. Yeah, that'll spawn some resources for me. Okay, here we go. Second action, move. He engages. And then I remember that in the flea market, pickpocketing costs 2 less. So I'll play this pickpocketing. Let's move things around so we can organize it all. Play that for free. Now, third action, I'll evade this guy. I'll be at 3 versus 2. That's it. That's it. I gotta do better than that. Let's go to 4 versus 2. I do want to succeed by more, though. Let's go with 4 versus 2. Hope for the best. Tablets. -3, and if you fail, take a direct horror. Man, this was a bad idea. Okay, so we failed. We've taken a horror. I think that was it. We're at 3. Yeah. Where's that moxie when I need it? Okay, so this might have been a terrible idea. Okay, so now we're going to go to the enemy phase where he attacks. 1 damage to us, 1 damage to Mr. Rook. Okay. And then we'll... Yep, go to upkeep. So Lola gets... Let's see, did she use her swap yet? I don't think she actually... Yeah, we'll just take it. Okay, card and resource over here. Card and resource. Okay. New turn. We're at 3 doom out of 6. We probably should get moving here. And we get some cards. Okay, another Dragon Dance Parade. So let's roll that die. That's a... what's that? Oh, that's a 1. So that's going to... It's in the north. Okay. So that's troublesome. And then what do we got here? Shanghaied. Okay, so if she fails this, she gets sent to, I guess, here. That's 2 spaces away. No, 3 spaces away. Okay. It's not the worst thing in the world. She's at 4 versus 4 right now on this. Let's use Mens Perfecta. So now we're at 6 versus 4. This means we'll be more prepped to deal with that. Okay, 6 versus 4 feels pretty good. Oh, during the test, let's use our last Mr. Rook charge. Okay, look at the, I guess, all but the bottom 1. So, yeah, it won't even let me cut that low. Interesting. Okay, so we look at this card. Yeah, we look at these 9. All right, what do we got here? Let's see. Could use. I'm trying to do evasions right now. A backstab might actually be handy, though. I can take this guy down. Oh, I can't, because I gotta get through his scales of the dragon. Although, I think a backstab will be how I take him out. Okay, so let's grab the backstab. Okay. Okay. Then, there we go. Okay, so currently I'm testing at 3, 4, 5, 6 versus 4. If I fail it, I don't know, stuff happens. 6, let's go, we don't need this, so we'll go 7, 8. Let's go all in on this one. 8 versus 4. Okay. 8 minus 3. Oh, I wanted to succeed by 2. Okay, so we make the test against Shanghai, so we're okay. Don't get my quick thinking, though. Don't get my resource. Yuck. Okay. So that was that. So now we're here. We want to evade. We'll use Corpus Perfectum to be at 5 versus 2. Feeling good about this. I am low on money now. Okay, so we're at 5 versus 2. Oh, awful. Awful. Okay. Try again. We'll be at 3 versus 2. Yeah, this guy's beating us up. Oh, triggered Lone Wolf. It's not working very... We're having some poor luck here. All right, second action, we'll go again. We'll be at 3 versus 2. Minus 1, succeed on the nose. So I can use them to get cards or resources. Let's just get resources. Okay. So he's stuck there, evaded. Okay, so the first damage dealt with him is going to get blocked by the scales. So I'm thinking maybe if I just stab him... Yeah, I can stab him with the Enchanted Blade. I'd be at 3 versus 4. Yuck. Okay, never mind. Okay, so we're having a little bit of trouble here. What do I do? We're having a little trouble with fighting. Okay, maybe something to get this flipped. So if I try to investigate here in order to clear... try to clear this. I'd be at 5... Okay, I'll just do that. So I'm gonna third action, I'm gonna investigate. So I'll be at 3, 4, 5, 6 versus 4. I'm gonna try to clear Unspeakable Oath. Nice. Okay, 6 versus 4. I succeed by 1. I want to succeed by 2, but it's okay. This is cleared. Yeah. Okay, but that gets that flipped for next turn. Okay. Oh, I succeeded by 1, so I get to do this. Okay, so that's the top card, that's the middle card, that's the bottom card. What the heck is this? Oh gosh. Baku, Eater of Dreams. Weapons may not be used by on attacking him. He's victory 2, though. But we use our willpower to defeat him. Fortunately, Lola's willpower is actually pretty good. It's going to spawn at Golden Temple of the Heavens. Okay, so he's going to spawn a little farther away from us. All right, that's good. All right, we'll deal with him when the time comes. And then Trish is going to get Taste of Dreams. Okay. That's not the worst thing in the world. She'll have to deal with it. Okay. She takes a horror for this, which means rather Rook does. Okay, so this is all three of Trish's actions. And was that all three of Lola's actions? I don't know. It's been a long turn. Yeah, it kind of was. Yeah, because Lola went move. Yeah, that's correct. Okay, so that was kind of a long turn. Huh. I feel like we're in a tough spot right now. Hopefully Lola will save the day with some gambling. All right, so we're going to go to upkeep, where he's going to come back. Okay, now we're going to go cards and resources. Card, resource. Okay, Derringer. What do we got here? Okay. Card, resource. Willpower is good, because she's about to make a willpower check. Okay, new turn. We go to 4 Doom out of 6, and let's get encounter cards. Right, Baku, Eater of Dreams. So he's going to spawn at the Golden Temple of the Heavens, and we're going to worry about him later. The Taste of Dreams. Okay, so we're going to do... Okay, so difficulty's 3. We're going to be at 5 to deal with it. 5. 5 looks good. Let's go 6 by burning this Mr. Rook that I don't think we need anymore. Okay, so we're going to be at 6 versus 3. Minus 2, succeed by 1. Ah, I want to succeed by 2. Okay, so we succeed. Okay, and we're fine there. Okay, so let's see how the combat keep... Let's see how Trish does on this in this combat here. Okay, so she's going to attack with the Enchanted Blade. She does that. She's at 5 versus 4. Kind of awful. So do I want to use this or do I want to use this on the agility check? We can start with evading, actually. Let's think about this. So if I start with evading, I can get some cards and resources. All right, so I'd be at 3 versus 2 to evade. I need to like boost myself a little more. We're gonna have Lola go first, actually, because if she finds some clues, then Trish might be able to spend them up here in order to go see what that is. Okay, so we're gonna have Lola go first. She's at the tea garden. Okay. Succeeding at investigate tests gets her resources. Right now she's at 5 versus 3 to investigate. I want to bump that up a bit more. Okay, 6 versus 3 feels good. So we'll use Tetsuo. Okay, so we're going to be testing at 6 versus 3 to go gambling. Okay, we succeed on the nose. That's good. Okay, so she's going to get a resource and get 2 clues. Okay, that's good. Okay, so what can she do with her other actions? Hallowed Mirror is not going to be all that necessary. I could keep investigating. I'd be at only 4 versus 3, though. Put in the Prophesy. Seems all right. I could save that for next turn, though. Yeah, I guess next turn she'll grab the clues. Another thing she could do is check out this location. Yeah, that's what we'll do. Yep, that's what we'll do. We'll spend some clues to go check out the location. Okay, what is it? As an action, draw the encounter card underneath this location. Okay, what is it? Oh, it's the Dragon's Den. Okay, so it says attach it to this location. Okay, so there are 2 clues here. Okay, how does this work? The Dragon's Den and the location from which it is drawn are connected to each other. The Dragon Den gains any traits of location connected to it. Non-elite long tongue enemies at this location gets +1 fight. Okay, so we're going to advance the act if we go in there and get those clues. Okay, so we like victory points, so I think we're going to have Lola grab these clues next turn and then head into the Dragon's Den. So this means that what Trish needs to do, she doesn't have to worry about this guy, she just needs to evade him and leave. Okay, so now Lola has a third action. What can I do with it? I'm going to save that for next turn. Now let's get the Hallowed Mirror in play. It's probably sooner rather than later. Okay, do that. Okay, so we've got a Soothing Melody, and then we've got 2 Soothing Melodies in the deck. Okay, that's her actions. Over to Trish. Trish is getting beat up a bit. She needs to evade this guy and then get out. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to evade. We're going to be at 3, use Corpus Perfectum, be at 5 versus 3. Yep. Oh, she gets Lone Wolf. 5 versus 3. Succeed by 2. Very good. So we're going to get a resource off of Trish's ability. We're going to draw 2 cards. We're going to get 2 resources. And that's and all's well. Okay, so he's evaded. Okay, whoops. Okay, so leaving that location causes her to lose 2 resources. Let's get Gregory Gry into play. Yeah, let's do that. Second action, Gregory Gry, because he only costs 1. Well, here. Okay, third action, we'll move out, and that'll cause us to lose 2 resources, and that'll cause us to lose any more actions that we have. So it doesn't do anything to us. Next turn, it'll do something to us, though. Okay, so that's all our actions. We're going to go to upkeep. Well, Hunter, we're going to go to enemy phase. So this thing will hunt. So it'll hunt here. Okay. It's going to come here next. Okay. And then this guy's during upkeep. This guy's going to refresh. We'll get cards and resources. Okay. Art student seems decent, but we've got Peter Sylvester, so we're going to be okay. Then we're going to get a card and a resource here. Okay, Calling a Favor is always nice to see, but there's no allies left. Okay, new turn. We're at 5-6, and let's get some encounter cards. What's coming? Another Scales of the Dragon. Okay, so this guy he can block all sorts of attacks, so we're just going to stay away from him. Okay, we have a Dragon's Dance Parade, so we're going to reroll the die here. Okay, somewhere besides 1. 4, so it goes west here. Okay. Okay, so that one is gone. Okay, now what? Okay, so Lola needs to grab those clues and head in. Okay. So let's have Lola go first. She wants to use Fingerprint Kit to do it. Another possibility is Trish can go first, head in, and then Lola can come in and heal her. That seems like an even better idea, to be honest. Okay, so Trish goes first. Trigger Lone Wolf. Okay, so we're going to go First action, move. Second action, move. Okay. I could just play Intel Report and end it. Do I have to advance when that happens? Yeah. So what else can I do? I don't want to advance till next turn. I could investigate. Nah. Oh yeah, I could investigate. So I don't want to use Intel Report. Another possibility is I can have her go move, then investigate, then move in. That way Lola won't have to. Nah, Lola's the one who's going to be. She's playing Mahjong. So let's do an investigate and see if we can do this without spending our Intel Report. So right now we're at 4-5 versus 3. We'll go 6-7 versus 3 with Mens Perfecta. So 7 versus 3 feels good. We succeed by 2, so we get a resource from Trish. Whoops. Okay. Get a resource from Trish. We're going to trigger that as well. So that's going to cause her to cause Gregory Guy. Oh, I forgot to bet with Gregory Guy. I would have bet 2 here. So that would have caused 2 more resources. And then this is going to trigger, causing a horror to Gregory. And we're going to get the 2 clues. And then I think we can advance when we want to. So we'll advance next turn. Okay, there they are. Okay. And we'll trigger the idol. So we're going to get that. This looks kind of awful, so let's just shuffle the deck. Okay. Come on. Come on, Tabletop Simulator. Just make piles when I want to. Okay, here we go. So we'll shuffle that. Okay. Don't have to investigate yet. Okay, so now Lola's going to come in. We're going to have her do some gambling. So we'll swap to Seeker. Use fingerprint kit, spend that. So right now she's at 5 versus 3. Burn the prophesy, so she'll be at 5, 6, 7 versus 3. Yeah, feels fine. Success, so she gains a resource from gambling, gets the 2 clues. So now that is another victory point for us. Okay. Second action, we'll move in. I can't heal her just yet, so I'm gonna have to swap to Guardian for that. So I think third action, I think we're just gonna chill and take a card. Card might cause horror. Yeah, I'll be fine. There it is. I had a feeling it was coming. So that's gonna cause us 2 horror, and we're gonna become a mystic. Okay. So that's all our actions. Hunters are gonna hunt, so he's gonna hunt here. He's also going to hunt here. Okay. We'll just remember he's got those. All right, now we're going to have cards and resources. Okay. Inquiring Mind, handy to see. Okay, she's out of that. She gets a card and a resource. Okay, more weapons. Don't really need them just yet. We've been getting away with just evading. So new turn. We are going to advance. What do we got? The Creeping Shadows. Forms move in the darkness of the streets as the shadows take life. You become increasingly aware of the almost infinite number of hiding spaces in the narrow roads. Discard cards from the encounter deck until a copy of Dragon Dance Parade is discarded. Okay. We'll do that. So we're going to look for a Dragon Dance Parade. Okay, there's got to be one in here somewhere. Okay, it's in here somewhere. I knew it. Where? Oh man, we're running out of cards here. Maybe there isn't one. Oh my gosh. Oh wow. So I guess we don't get one. Okay, and then we'll reshuffle the deck. Okay. Army of the Forbidden City. The members of the Long Tong appear to have been lurking in every doorway and fire escape in the district, waiting for you to get dangerously deep into their territory. You'd better find who you're looking for quick, or risk dissipating into the district just like another opium-fueled dream. Long Tong enemies gain Hunter. Okay. So if they didn't have it before, they have it now. Okay, so now we're going to get encounter cards. Dragon Dance Parade, funny. Okay, so let's roll this. Okay, one, so it goes back to being to the north. Discard that. Okay, and what do we got here? We've got Gifts of the Orient. You must either take 2 horror and draw 2 cards, or put a doom on the agenda. I don't think she's in a good position to take 2 horror. I don't think so. So I'll just put a doom on the agenda. It'll be okay. We're doing okay here. Okay, so let's advance while we're here. Okay, so what do we get? Moment of truth. After fighting your way through the front rooms, you batter down the backroom door at the dragon's den. If you're on agenda 1, 2, or 3, then Feng Shao lies in the corner of the room, hands bound behind his back. In between you and him stands one of the Tong warriors. It looks like there's more than one hurdle to jump. Spawn the set aside Ling Xingxuan at Gateway to the East. Okay, so let's grab Ling Xingxuan. Okay, right, I remember her from the club, except she's an enemy now. Discard cards from the top of the encounter deck until a long Tong enemy is revealed and spawn that at the Dragon's Den. Okay, so she's at the Gateway to the East, so she's victory points, so that's cool. She's got 6 hit points, she hunts, she retaliates, and she engages. Okay, when an investigator damages her, she engages that investigator. Okay. Oh, interesting. Investigators engage with Ling Xingxuan use willpower instead of to attack or evade her. That's interesting. This also kind of scary. Okay. Now we're going to find a Long Tong enemy. Oh, here he is. We got a sorcerer to deal with. And we're going to attach Feng Shao to that enemy. Okay, where is he? Oops, there he is. Okay. See, this Virtue of Dynasty, very rare. Okay, so we're going to have to rescue him. Advance to Act 3. Act 3, version 2-1, Flight from the Orient. Here we go. Okay, I guess there's 2 of them. All right, that makes sense. Flight from the Orient. Hurry, Feng shouts as you close on his detainer. She's on her way back. You're not entirely sure who he's talking about, but the goon in the room isn't going to give you any time to chat to figure it out either. The forceful and violent will not die of natural causes. Time to get Feng and get out of here. Okay, when an investigator defeats an enemy that Feng Shao is attached to, he or she gains control of Feng Shao. If an investigator is defeated by a Long Tong enemy, attach Feng Shao to that enemy. If each undefeated investigator has resigned and one investigator controls Feng Shao, advance. Okay, so we just gotta get out of here. We've got lots of stuff in our way, though. Okay, so this guy's gonna engage somebody. We haven't decided who's going first. So who's going to attack it? Probably Trish, because she can just backstab this guy. Okay, so he's attached. Okay, so this is before like we really start our turns. So I think I'm going to have Lola go first to like heal her up. Maybe not. Yeah, she could just start punching now. Oh, she's got to take a willpower test when it engages her. Currently, she is at 3 versus 3. Let's use Guts to go to 5 versus 3. And how important is this? It's fine. 5 versus 3. -1. We succeed by 1. So we get a card from Guts. And that's all. Okay. Maybe I should have bet, but oh well. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to have Trish just start attacking. It only has 2 hit points, so if we use the Enchanted Blade and we use Corpus Perfectum, we're going to be at 5, 6, 7 versus 2. Feels pretty good. Okay, succeed by 4, so we're going to trigger Trish to get a resource. Let's say I bet 2 again from Gregory. I just got to start remembering that. Okay, so I get 2 from Gregory, 1 from Trish. And I deal 2 damage to this guy. Discard him, which takes control of Feng Shao. Okay, he takes up a slot, so I see. So that's gonna we're gonna lose Gregory here. Ah. Okay. Okay, so there's all. Okay, so get pushed out of the slot. So we've got him now. You get an additional willpower, and after you play an item, you can exhaust him to draw a card. If the item is a relic or a cult card, draw 2 instead. Oh, that's kind of neat. Okay, so here we are. We've got control of him. That was our first action. We need now to get out of here. Okay, these two are going to jump on us, so let's not end our turns at the tea garden, because we'll let them hunt in, and then we'll go deal with them. So we need to build up to go deal with those guys. I think that's going to involve... We don't need the fingerprint kit anymore, so I think I'm going to play a Derringer. Oh, wait, let's not play a Derringer. It's not the leveled up one. We'll take a second Enchanted Blade, because that's better. Third action, I don't need Intel Report for anything. Is anything worth victory points that we haven't? I mean, this might be worth victory points. So third action, I could just draw. Okay. Draw is probably fine. We've got good resources, so let's do it. Lucky cigarette case. Well, I guess we don't need the idol anymore, so we could just put down the lucky cigarette case instead, because we're not really... We're beyond the investigate phase. All right, so we're going to stay here, and we're going to let these guys come in. This also means that Lola is going to need a weapon. All right, so what we'll do is, since she's a mystic, we'll drop the fingerprint kit. Nah, we'll drop the magnifying glass. If we need to investigate, we can use the fingerprint kit. Drop the magnifying glass. Play Enchanted Blade. Okay, that's first action. Second action... we'll swap the Guardian. Second action, play Soothing Melody to heal Trish's horror, because this scenario seems to be a bit more about horror. Okay, and draw a card. Okay, Inquiring Mind, nice to see. Third action. Lola's probably short on resources, if anything. Take a resource, end of her turn, heal Peter Sylvester. Okay, seems pretty good. Okay, so now we're going to go to enemy phase. Hunt and hunt. So this guy we're just going to evade because he's got two Scales of the Dragon attached to them. This guy... Oh, weapons may not be used. Yuck. All right, so we'll just have to make a bunch of willpower tests to deal with him. All right, we'll be fine. I think we'll be fine. All right, now we're going to go to upkeep. Card and resource. Ooh, that's nice to see. That's nice to see. And what we got here? Card and resource. Okay. New turn. We're at 2 doom out of 4. We still got another agenda left. All right. Get encounter cards. Well, of Babel again. If there is no, there are no clues on the location, so it's going to get Surge. Okay. Okay. Surges. Okay. We have a willpower test to make. If we fail it, we're going to either take damage or lose resources. Right now, we're at 4 versus 3. I think I'll just take it on the chin. Success, that's good. All right, what do we got over here? Oh, another Ling Tong enemy. Okay, so we have to make an agility test, and if we fail, must return a weapon asset to hand. Okay, so we're currently at 3 versus 3 on this. Maybe Lola can help? No, we can't play Inquiring Mind. Yep, 3 versus 3, and if we fail, we have to return a weapon to hand. I can return this Enchanted Blade that I'm not using. Okay, so that's not the worst thing in the world. Okay, Skull. Skull is a -0 right now, so we succeed, though on the nose. Okay, so we've got this guy. Oh, where'd he go? Oh, no, we didn't discard him. He's right here. So we've got to deal with this guy, and then we got to go evade this guy. And maybe I'll have Lola... I can have Lola deal with this guy. All right, so it sounds like Trish needs to go first so she can move in and evade. All right, kind of wish I had quick thinking at this point. All right, so first action, I'll attack this guy. I'll be at 3, 4, 5. 5 versus 3. All right, let's go for it. Success by 3, that's good. So we're going to get a card off, we're going to get a resource off of Trish, and that's all. So he's dealt with. Okay, second action, move out. She's going to engage this and this. Okay. We need to evade this guy because he's got some shields on him. So we're going to be, if we evade, we're going to be at 3 versus 2. Oh, I can also backstab this guy. Weapons may not be used, but backstabs can be used. I have to use my willpower. And thus Mens Perfecta. Got it. We have a plan. Okay, so second action. I'm going to play Backstab. Okay, so I'm going to be at 3. It's Willpower, right? Because for this fight check. 3, 4, 5, 6. six versus three. I could bust in. Let's do seven versus three. I don't want to mess this up. Okay. Oh, succeed by a zillion. Okay. So what happens when we succeed by a zillion? She's already used that. So all that happens is she just deals three damage to this guy. Okay. And goes to the victory display. That's cool. Okay. That was her second action. So third action, I think we'll evade this guy. We've got Corpus Perfectum now. So we're going to evade him at 3, 4, 5 versus 2. Let's do 6 versus 2. Oh, geez, not again. Wow, again. Okay, so he's evaded, but we evaded him by a bunch. So we're going to get 2 cards and 2 resources. How many? I only have 1 card left, so it's fine. Okay, 2 resources, 1 card, and then I'll take a horror. Or rather, he will, to get another card. Okay, that's good to see. Okay, so that was Trish's turn. I think Lola, we're going to have her probably sprint past. I mean, that's... Oh, we can just go down to the back alley. Okay. So this guy, Trish is going to have to evade him again. That is the problem we have here. Can Lola do something about that? Not really, because of those. So Lola's going to first action move here. She's... Oh, where'd he go? Oh, she's got him, so she's the one who needs to get away. Okay, she's going to hunt to here, so I guess we can end our turn here. Okay, we've got our weapon. We're good to go. I can't heal her yet. I mean, we could also just stick together so they can help each other out. Let's just get moving. Second action, move here. Third action. I don't need all these cards, so I'll probably just draw a card. Okay. Third action, draw a card. Easy mark. Okay. End of our turn. Peter heals. Okay. So we go to the enemy phase. She's going to hunt to here. Okay. Then upkeep. Okay. End of the invest. Oh, that's going to go away. Or rather, it's going to get shuffled into the encounter deck. This is going to re-engage Trish. Okay, and then we're going to go to upkeep, card, and resource. So she has too many cards. I don't think I'm going to need these Derringers, because tests against her are with willpower anyway. Okay, over here, card and resource. That's good to see. Okay, new turn. We are at 3 doom out of 4. Let's see what kind of encounter cards we get before we start rolling. Okay, he spawns at the House of Fighting Arts. Okay, and we got a Wall of Babel, which surges. Whoops, that goes here and goes into the there and surges. Oh, Shanghai. Okay, so if we fail this, where do we end up? Looks like we end up over there. Which is kind of bad for us, because yeah, we want to make this. Okay, so it's will. All right, and this is fine because it lets us use Mens Perfecta to flip it over again. Okay, so it is an intellect test. We are currently at 4. Use Mens Perfecta to go to 5, 6 intellects. We don't need this anymore, so we'll go 7, 8. 8 minus 3 is 5, so we succeed by 1 and get rid of that. Okay, so we need to evade this. And then start, and then move down this way, and we can start dealing with Lin Xingxuan. Okay, so Trish is going to go first, trigger Lone Wolf, first action, evade. We'll use Corpus Perfectum, and we're going to be at 3, 4, 5 to evade. 5 versus 2. Let's go 6 versus 2, 7, 8 versus 2. We are going for it. 8 minus 0. All right, we succeed by a zillion, so we get the action back. We also trigger our pickpocketings. Card. Card, resource. We trigger Trish, get a resource, and most importantly, he's evaded. And so we still have 3 actions left. We can roll in and deal with Lin Xingxuan at this point. I could also play the Lucky Cigarette case, so we don't have to jump on her just yet. Okay. Lola's probably better for Lola's probably better for dealing with her because Lola has Peter to soak up horror. So we'll go second action move here. Catch up with Lola. Third action. Yeah, let's discard the strange idol, play lucky cigarette case. Trigger him. It is not relic or occult, so we trigger him to draw a card. Okay. That's Trish. Lola, we're gonna go deal with her now. First action move. Engage Ling Xingxuan. Okay. I think we need to start attacking. So when I attack, I'm gonna be let's see. So I have to use my willpower. So right now I'm at 4 versus 3 to attack her. 4 versus 3, not so good. Use unexpected courage, we'll go to 6 versus 3. That feels a lot better. 6 minus 2, so I succeed and deal 2 damage to her. Okay. Third action, I'll attack again. This time I'll use an Inquiring Mind to be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 versus 3. Oh, on the nose, good. Okay, so I deal 2 more damage to her. Okay. So things are working out okay at this point. Okay, so now we go to enemy phase. Lin Xingxuan attacks. She's going to deal a damage and 2 horror. So we'll do that. Okay, and then this is going to refresh. This is going to hunt. Okay. So we just need to stay away from these two. All right, upkeep. Card, resource. Don't need that. Card, resource. Okay. New turn. We're gonna advance. This is it. Let's see what happens. Rivals and revels. It seems as if the entire gang has been sent out to meet you, and the streets of the already cramped district become almost impossible to navigate as celebrations and violence go on with no signs of ending. Okay, so we're gonna go find a dragon dance parade. Okay, there's gotta be one. I mean, they have to be in here now. All right, here we go. So this one's gonna get discarded. Then we're gonna roll to see where this one goes. 4, so 1, 2, oh, right where Trish is. Okay, that's fine, we'll deal with it. The events of the evening have left the streets of Chinatown in total chaos. You begin to regret stepping foot in the gates and hope to just be lucky enough to see the morning. Okay, Long Tongers are going to continue to hunt us. Okay, so we'll start with Lola, see if she can finish her off. She's doing well so far. First action attack, we're going to be at 4 versus 3. We'll use Inquiring Mind to go up to 7 versus 3. Okay, success. So she takes down Lin Xingxuan. Okay. And puts that in the victory display. All right. Second action will move. Let's not resign yet because I think I want to see if there's any victory points here. So I'll go up here. No victory points. So we can just leave. All right, so Trish, however, she's gonna get her She's gonna get her lone wolf, but she's gonna have to spend 2 actions to go here, okay, and a 3rd action to go here. I mean, there's nothing else to do, is there? No, not really. Okay, I think we're gonna be okay. All right, so that ends our actions. These two guys are gonna hunt down to here. Actually, they're gonna hunt here because they're going after Lola now. Okay. Card resource. And then card resource. Okay. New turn. 4, 1 doom out of 4. Let's see what kind of encounter cards we get. Ooh, Shanghai, this could be bad, because then she could get sent all the way back up there. That would be really bad. So she doesn't want to fail this. So she's currently at 3 versus 4. Gosh. All right, we're just going to pitch everything into it. Oh, that was supposed to happen. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 versus 4. 7 minus 0. Okay, so we succeed and we are not sent up to the flea market because that would have been bad. Okay, this guy engage. This guy jumps on Trish, so she has to make a check to see if one of her enchanted blades goes back to hand. This is not that big of a problem, so we'll just take it on the nose. That is going to be a success because we are at 3 versus 3. Okay. All right, so we'll start with Trish, see if we can get her resigned. She will first action attack. So we're going to be at 5 versus 3. Yep, 5. Let's go 6 versus 3. Okay, success by at least 2. So we do that. We get a lucky cigarette case, and we deal with this guy. Okay, anything else she can do to help Lola out? Not really. So she'll resign. Whoops. Yep, we'll just resign. Yep, and then Lola will go move, resign. Okay, so we made it out of Chinatown, and then we advance the act. Oh, that was a really interesting scenario, actually. I really enjoyed this one. I enjoyed how some strange bad guys, we've got some strange strange treacheries. I like the use of willpower and sanity. So that was actually a pretty good scenario. I really like that one. It's got a little bit of blood in the altar type stuff. That could potentially drag you down. I don't know if it needs to be 2 clues per investigator. It seems like a lot to just check on the card. But I don't know. Okay, so let's advance. Okay, and what do we get? Home sweet home. As you run out the gates of Chinatown, you feel like you've never been so happy to see the filthy streets of New York. Resolution 6. Okay, here we go. All right, resolution 6. Resolution 6. That's a lot of resolutions. Oh, nice. Eager to put as much distance as you can between you and the snapping jaws of the dragon, you take the most elaborate way back to your office as you can, daring to go down the darkest alleys you'd not venture through on any other night. Just when it seems like you may have lost your way, you look up and see the glowing sign of the Imperial pointing away to a more familiar and welcoming slum. Knowing you're back on your home turf, you calmly make your way back to the office, eager to collapse in your desk chair. Feng follows you up and sits down on your couch, the frenzy of the evening betraying his normal calm. Minutes pass before any of you say a word. Finally, Feng speaks, his distraught state replaced by a statuesque peace. My friends, to think when I sent Lu out for help, it should be you he would find. Truly the heavens work in our favor. Feng's words restore a sense of ease in you, and you remember the reason you sought him out in the first place, as you dig in your pockets for the idol. Dark things are afoot. Forces are mobilizing to find something that should have stayed hidden. The dragon was just one of those who seeks it. You see, they are looking for... Feng stops as he sees the idol you pull from your pocket. You have it? One investigator must add Feng Shao to his or her decklist. This does not count towards that investigator's decklist. Each investigator gains experience equal to the Victrix value of each card in the victory display. So we've got 2 for the Baku Eater of Dreams, 2 for Ling Xing Xuan. We've got, so that's 4, 5 for the Dragon's Den, 6 for the Tea Garden, 7 for the House of Fighting Arts, 8 for the Flea Market. So it looks like we've got, yeah, we did a clean sweep. We got all 8. Well done. Okay, anything else here? Because it looks like it cut off pretty suddenly. Oh, we've got an interlude. Oh, do not read unless investigators read resolution 5. Okay, we did resolution 6. Okay, what do we got here? Prologue. Okay, so this is, looks like that's for the next scenario. Okay, we got resolution 6. Okay, so that's that. Okay, so we've got 8 XP, which is quite a bit. That went pretty well. One of us is going to be putting Feng Shao in the deck. This one could go either way, but not really sure yet. It's probably going to be Lola, but I'll think about it. Okay, so that went pretty well, and we didn't get to see Lola's crystalline elder sign in action, so hopefully we will next scenario. So once again, thank you so much for watching, and have a great night.